Drug maker Pfizer is set to meet with health officials to talk about authorizing a COVID booster shot. But medical experts in the Bay Area, in fact across the world, say that is not where the focus should be. Crown 4's Dan Kerman explains.
As Pfizer asks U.S. officials to authorize a third dose or booster in this country, Israel has become the first nation to begin administering a third dose of the vaccine to older people and those most at risk, adults with weakened immune systems. Yet despite the expansion of the more transmissible Delta variant, federal and local health experts say the science indicates a booster is not warranted because two doses of the vaccine are keeping people alive and out of the hospital.
Most of the deaths are in unvaccinated individuals.
UCSF infectious disease specialist Dr. Peter Chin Hong says while older people and those immunocompromised may at some point benefit from a booster, he says that is not where the focus should be now.
It seems like playing whack-a-mole by giving some people three shots, four shots, instead of just focusing in on immunizing as many people as possible around the world, because if you really want to stop variants like Delta, and who knows what's going to be worse in the future, like an Omega or Zeta, you should immunize as many people as possible to stop the transmission in the first place.
The priority now must be to vaccinate those who have received no doses and protection.
Monday, the World Health Organization went further, calling out drug makers for promoting a booster when many countries haven't had enough shots to vaccinate their healthcare workers.
Instead of Moderna and Pfizer prioritizing the supply of vaccines as boosters to countries whose populations have relatively high coverage, we need them to go all out to channel supply to COVAX, the Africa Vaccine Acquisition Task Team, and low and middle income countries, which have very low vaccine coverage.
And disparities are also prevalent here in the United States. While many Bay Area counties have some of the highest vaccination rates in the nation, states like Mississippi, which have some of the lowest rates, are now encouraging those at risk to avoid indoor gatherings and those unvaccinated to continue to wear their masks in public. In San Francisco, Dan Kerman, Crown 4 News.